I'm Christine Meijnersma. I'm a product designer. So this is a flex plant. And from this plant, you can make all kinds of lovely linen fabric. It's like an old material that's been used in Holland for a long time. I found out that flex is still grown in the western part of Europe. And 90% of the flex is exported to China. But there is still 10% left. And in my project, I was really interested in finding out what is this 10%? Who are these people working with this material? I found out that actually composites made of sustainable resins was really a sort of future aspiration for people working with flex. I decided I wanted to make a chair is because I wanted to show the material in a really intimate product. I wanted to design a really simple shape from one piece of fabric, and I didn't want to waste any material. What I came up with is to cut a square piece of 1 meter by 60 centimeter of both the fabric and the felt. What I do with this square piece is I cut it in 3 shapes. While we were pressing, we actually figured out that we could make a stack of fabrics and put it into the mold, and it presses the whole chair in one press, and then later on the pieces are cut loose. We did use 2 screws, but for the rest, the complete construction is of one and the same material, which is this flex PLA composite. It's a biodegradable chair, which you could also shred and repress. So it has the possibility to, in the future, become a completely circular product.
The chair sits in the furniture collection of the V&A, and it currently is on display in the Design 1900 to Now gallery in a particular area which is focused on sustainable materials and manufacturing. The furniture industry is increasingly aware of the impact that it has on the environment. Starting from the desire to work with local materials, Christine set out on a research journey that took many years. It shows the importance of a careful and considered approach to making, and I think it's something that we all need to take into consideration with making sustainable furniture and products.
My advice for anybody who wants to be a designer would be to not only do your research behind your computer, but to talk to people, to meet people, to go to places, because you will always find out things you never imagined.